Hey guys, in this video we're going to dive in to pressure advance on Klipper using the Sonic Pad. But okay, now that's out of the way, I'm going to break this into five simple steps. First, we're going to talk about what pressure advance is and why it can be critical to maximize your 3D printing, what you're going to need to get this done, the slicer settings and the Klipper settings to get pressure advance up and running on your 3D printer, and a practical demonstration to show you the difference that it makes once you've got it up and running. I hope that you guys are gonna enjoy this, so stick around and let's get into it. Step one, what is pressure advance and why can it be critical for your 3D printing? Pressure advance is essentially an upgrade to your 3D printer's extrusion configuration. It allows Klipper to properly manage the amount of filament your printer extrudes. In other words, when your printer goes around a corner, the acceleration changes. But without pressure advance, the extruder will keep pushing filament out because of all the pressure built up in the extruder, even though the acceleration substantially slowed down. This kind of gives a drifting effect, like a fast car going around a corner. Okay, so take a look at this architectural model of the house me and my wife are building that I printed out, and you can see what I mean. If you look over here, you can see that there's a little bit of a bulge in the corner there. So pressure advance solves that problem right quick, resulting in unparalleled control and precision, helping you get prints that are mostly free from the frustrating flaws that could be so prevalent at higher speeds. Things like stringing, boogers, and bulging corners, leaving you super smooth corners and stunning final products, letting you print faster and more accurately at the same time, making you a lot more successful whether you're running a business or using 3D printing as a hobby. Pressure advance will definitely boost you to a new level. So stick around, let me show you how you can maximize your 3D printing. And at the end, we're gonna reprint that house and I'm gonna show you the difference it makes. Step two, the tools that you need to get the job done. So the first thing that you're gonna need to get pressure advance done on your 3D printer is Klipper. For the purpose of this video, we're gonna be using the Sonic Pad, which in my opinion is the number one best bang for your buck upgrade you can get for your 3D printer. I have a video review of the Sonic Pad. You can check it out. I left a link for it down in the description, along with everything else I'm using in this video. So the next thing you're gonna need is the Tuning Tower STL file. The last thing is a caliper, which you're gonna need to measure for the sweet spot in the Tuning Tower. Caliper is also a super useful item when it comes to 3D printing in general, and must have if you have a 3D printer. I left an affiliate link for a great one down in the description. Okay, so now that we have everything that we need, let's get into the slicer settings. So now that we have our Tuning Tower STL, we can pop it right into Cura. At this point, because we're gonna be printing in PLA for this tutorial, we're going to pick the PLA preset setting. It's important to point out that according to Klipper, technically, you should redo pressure advance for each filament you use, and even each color of filament, and every time you change your nozzle. But personally, I don't find this to be necessary. Once I set it up, pressure advance seems to work just fine on all the different filaments I use, on most of the different filaments. Once that's out of the way, we can move on to the important stuff, the actual slicer settings for the Tuning Tower. At this point, we're going to change the layer height to 75% of the nozzle diameter, which in this case is 0.3 because we're using a 0.4 nozzle. Next, we're gonna cut the infill down to zero and ramp the speed up to 100 millimeters a second. And if you have acceleration control enabled, it's gotta be turned off at this point so we can accentuate the effects of the over-extruded corners. And with that, we're done the slicer settings. Once we're done with that, now we can configure everything on Klipper straight from your computer. Here, all you gotta do is copy and paste the right command straight into Klipper. So let's jump in and let me show you. The first thing we gotta do is paste the command to prepare Klipper to start the test. This is the set velocity command. This essentially tells Klipper to slow the extruder down around corners so it'll be easier to see the bulge in the corners and make it easier to measure. Next, we're going to paste the pressure advance command. It's important to make sure you paste the right command here because there's one for direct drive extruders and another one for Bowden tubes. So make sure you get the right one. This is the tuning tower command. So this command lets the printer know this is the pressure advance test we're running, and it changes the pressure advance level on each layer so we can find the sweet spot, and this command cancels out right after we finish the print. Once we got that done, we can finally bang out the tuning tower. Okay, so once we finish banging out the tuning tower, let's take a look at it and see if we can see the difference. I don't know if you can see this on camera, but there's a clear difference in the bulge from the bottom to the top. My printer seems to be best at the bottom. Yours might differ in that regard. So what we're looking for essentially is the sweet spot between the layers, where the over-extruded corners stop and before the under-extruded bits start. On my printer, I seem to have a little bit more trouble with under-extrusion, but yours might be different. Once we find that sweet spot, we can measure the difference to it from the bottom of the print with that caliper we got out earlier. And the way we get the pressure advance value is by following some simple maths. The starting point plus the measuring height times the factor. Assuming you started printing the tuning tower from layer 0, you can disregard that first part of the equation. We multiply the height we measured on the tuning tower by 0.005, which is the factor that we used for the direct drive extruder in the command we gave to Klipper earlier. If you're using a Bowden tube, it will be 0.02. So for the purpose of this video, our pressure advance value is 0.03895. So what now? By the way, if you guys feel like you're getting any value out of this video, I would love it if you could subscribe or like the video. That way I can keep getting better and putting out more content for you. Well, now all we gotta do, put our pressure advance value into the extruder section of the configuration file. Here you can see that Klipper rounded the pressure advance value from 0.03895 to 0.04. Now we issue the restart command. The restart command will clear the test state and return the acceleration and corner speeds to their normal values. And we're done. I printed out the STL file for the house again. The last time I printed it out at 50 millimeters a second, but this time I printed it out at 150 millimeters per second. And take a look at the difference. This is incredible. I don't know if you can really see this on camera. I'm gonna try to put in some B-roll and show you a little bit better, but this is totally different. I don't know if you can see the difference between the corners over here and over here, but that is massively better. So I hope that you can see now how pressure advance can really boost your 3D printing, and we'll see you in the next one. Thanks guys, bye.